love is what has brought us here. With the courage to come near,
my favorite thing about my experience at Queen's is that I have the ability to interact with so many different people with varied opinions. So as a student in the Department of Microbiology and Immunology, I'm also part of the Collaborative Cancer Program run by Queen's. And because of that, I am able to interact with people that study biochemistry and pharmacology and neurology, pathology and molecular medicine, epidemiology and community health. And all of these fields offer such a distinct and rare perspective on cancer research that it's really important that we talk to each other and that we share information. And so that is one thing that is definitely unique to Queen's that is absolutely fantastic. My interest is way at the beginning, so cancer initiation. What happens to a normal breast epithelial cell, which makes it stop specializing and doing what it's supposed to do, and then move towards cancer? And that's what I study. So in order to know if my proteins not only are important in that despecialization and are also important later in the actual human cancer sample, that's where the clinical part of my research comes in. So I'm able to go and see if my proteins are still there. And I think that's really powerful, because if I can show that they're not only important at cancer initiation, but that protein is still important so much further on in the cancer cascade when a person actually has an invasive tumor, then maybe if we can inhibit those proteins right at the start before that patient gets cancer, we can prevent the entire situation. One of the things that people outside of research and outside of what we do don't necessarily consider is how much it costs to conduct basic science research. Everything has a price, from the reagents and the consumables we use, so things like the nutrient media that grows our cells, and glassware, and the equipment we use, you know, just the cost of day-to-day running experiments, and have to be run more than once so that we have statistically significant results we can show that are consistent. And in order to do that, there is just such an enormous cost, especially, you know, imaging equipment and microscopes and being able to visualize cells. They're just so tremendously expensive. From all of the students who are given an opportunity to do research at Queen's, we would just like to say thank you to all of the people who have chosen to give gifts to Queen's, which allows students like us to have opportunities to make a difference in cancer research. Thank you. Oh, so there.